start of the official campaign period. Akala niyo nakakuha niya na mali ang ginagawa nila. Kaya hindi sila nakating dito ngayon. It's the first day of the official campaign period. Last month, nag-usap-usap kami na saan kami mag-inaugurate o mag-launch ng aming presidential and vice presidential candidacy. Some suggested the North, some the South, because I come from the Visayas. Some wanted the rally or whatever event might happen inside Metro Manila, some outside Metro Manila. Pero bandang huli dahil marami na masyado nagsasalita, Chaco, dalhin niyo ako sa campus where I have always been most comfortable with an audience, but not only an audience consisting of ordinary students. I want a campus with a high IQ.
Leaders in your community. It is time that the Marcos and
if I die before I finish my 6-year term, I'll confirm my heart was bigger, be able to take me to get that. who is perhaps one of the most misunderstood, abused, and outdated concepts in modern history. Patriotism and nationalism are similar but distinct phenomena. The lessons for the Philippines are clear. As a relatively small nation, it was precisely the lack of nationalism that allowed foreign predators to unlimited hunger and exploit our country. Yun ang nangyari sa atin. Dahil wala tayong tinawag na a sense of shared destiny. Pare-pareho ang kalagayan natin. Kaya kung may basura sa likod ng bahay mo, huwag mo tatang kung sa neighbor mo. Because what hurts your neighbor will ultimately hurt you. So we can have a sense of shared destiny. Kaya tinanggap-tawa ng mundo. Ikahati kami doon sa North Bongo, dito ako sa South. Magagalagyan mo yun. Pag wala na ako, si Bongo naman. Bibigyan mo na lang siya ng payo. Kung gabi, nanatutulog silang dalawa ni Lisa. More than nationalism, which means emotional attachment to our culture, food, and traditions, we also need more patriotism. The West Philippine Sea disputes pitting a valiant Southeast maritime nation against a Chinese government would serve as a catalyst for a new sense of unity among ourselves, regardless of our ethnicity, religion, and social class. We can fulfill these duties of citizenship by voting responsibly for patriotic leaders who have betrayed our national interests and voting out those who have betrayed our national interests and or directly participating in the policy-making realm, whether as elected officials, career bureaucrats, advisors. Maski sa inyo na lang ba pwede tumakbo? Hindi dapat sa inyo, mga estudyante, tinatingnan niyo yung mga kandidato, kung magaling sila sa academics, ng subjects, kung meron silang malasakit, and so on. Ngayon, makikita mo sa elections natin na maski sinong gago pwede mo ako. Pagkatapos, pupunta na sila ngayon sa senaryo sa Kongreso at mag-deliver ng printed speech na haba-haba-haba tumataas ang bill nilang pabayaran nila ng cultural cliente. Wala naman tayo mapapala sa mga pinagsasabihin nila. We should not descend into divisiveness. We should have a sense of shared destiny. But we should not follow who climbed and sinker, but these alleged leaders want us to believe. Tingnan natin yung nakinatakot ngayon. Merong isang, hindi na sigurado kung saan kami ang anak.
Is more difficult.
than analysis. Kaya, dapat dito, magtibay ang tingin ng Pilipino. The Ilocanos were famous in Philippine history for their grittiness. They had true grit. They defended their country. Did not wait before the superior military warfare of the invaders. That is what we are called to do. We, of course, should pursue a career, not always in politics, but at least we should do what we can within our province, among our family, among our friends and neighbors. Tell them, the presidency is not a TV show called That's Entertainment. Piliin nyo yung number one, may academic excellence. Or, hindi naman kailangan na may honors. Basta na eskwela ka, ito na pakagaling eskwelahan, at least na-expose ka na. Number two,
of your soul.